The reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows a believer to go through certain stages at times is in order for us to realize that the mistake was right at the beginning. The minute we fall ill, the minute calamity strikes, the first thing we need to do is turn to Allah. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. So many times a day we repeat, you alone we worship, you alone we ask for help. I will worship Allah alone and I will ask for Allah for help. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then facilitate for me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then facilitate for me and grant me the ability to do that which is correct, to do that which is filled with blessing from every angle. There is no point in being cured medically and physically when spiritually we are ill, we are sick, when religiously we are far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So mankind, due to his weakness, starts off on the wrong side by relying primarily upon the medication or the doctor or whoever else it may be, or himself or his expertise or whatever he's read or knows, and nowadays even on Google, subhanallah. So you find Allah is removed from the equation. And this is where we falter. The difference between a believer and one who does not believe is that the believer primarily turns to Allah. Before everything, we say Bismillah. We are taught that when you leave the house, you say Bismillahi, tawakkaltu ala Allah. In the name of Allah, I lay my trust in Allah. And we would lock the door. Thereafter, whatever you're doing, if it is anything of importance, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, kullu amalin lam yabda fihi bi bismillahi fahuwa aqta. Anything that you're going to do, if you haven't started it with bismillah, it is going to be cut, chopped. Chopped means the blessing of it, the reward of it, the goodness of it. Even if physically you achieved some form of success, because you removed Allah from the equation, that was the mistake you made, and therefore the blessing will be snatched away. The goodness is snatched away.